It is that time of the year again. You play any Pokemon game? Have your high-level Pokemon squad with you with names such as Denkadoodles? Already collected most gym badges? And probably run through more tall grass than the average lawnmower? And one day, because you are kinda bored, or on a long train or car ride, you go through the Pokedex and listen to their sounds, read their descriptions, details and go... Eh? Fans of the series know that the Pokedex entries sometimes tend to go... C-dots. But today I want to focus on the different sizes of them, because some of them are kinda terrifying. But before I just show it, I will read about two of its descriptions from the different Pokedex entries, so that you can maybe picture how small or big it could be. Of course, you can pause the video if you like and guess before I show the answer. Anyway, our starter Pokemon, haha, is... Haunter. In total darkness, where nothing is visible, Haunter lurks, silently stalking its next victim. It hides in the dark, planning to take the life of the next living thing that wanders close by. Okay, yeah, that does sound kinda spooky, but Haunter is just a cute little purple- Oh my goodness! Oh, I couldn't believe what I've read there! I thought Haunter was the size of a backpack or something and not of a shelf! And the other entries don't help either. Seriously, I underestimated that purple fella. But that, of course, was only the beginning. Let's go to the next one, which would be... Blastoise. It crushes its foe under its heavy body to cause fainting. In a pinch, it will withdraw inside its shell. It deliberately makes itself heavy so it can withstand the recoil of the water jets it fires. Man, combined with this look, this dude surely has to be the size of a small car or something. Nope. It actually is as tall as Haunter. This is so backwards. Haunter should be smaller than this and Blastoise way bigger. To put this into another perspective, I'm taller and heavier than this freaking tank of a turtle. So maybe let's get away from ghosts and turtles with cannons on their back to something more normal like a bird. Like Pidgey. A common sight in forests and woods. It flaps its wings at ground level to kick up blinding sand. Yeah, nothing really spectacular about this one. It has pretty much the same height and weight as the real pigeon. Which is however still a bit shorter than I imagined them. I always thought they would be as big as a small dog or something. Huh. Honestly, I love the thought of this little guy fighting a huge as Wailord or Gyarados. Okay, I know. No one fights with a freaking Pidgey or Taillow against a Gyarados. How would that even look like? Anyway, to the next one! Nidoking and Nidoqueen are pretty much the same size, so I will read one entry from each of them. Its hard scales provide strong protection. It uses its hefty bulk to execute powerful moves. It uses its thick arms, legs and tail to attack forcefully. Melee combat is its speciality. And hell yeah, they are buff. But they are kinda tiny. And to be fair here, I never really imagined them to be 6'5" or something, but still taller than 11-year-old me. Next! Okay, now we have Golbat and Crobat. I will only read Crobat's description, but these two are pretty much the same size too. Remember this. So check this out. Its fangs are so sharp, if it bites you in the dark and sucks your blood, you won't notice any pain or realize you've been bitten.
What?
Wait. Yes, of course. The obviously best way to steal blood unnoticed is being as tall as a teenager. And if you are Golbat, screw it, just eat him with one bite. Okay, so next on the list would have been Snorlax, but he's 6'11" and given how wide he is, yeah, this is how I imagined him. So let's skip him and go to the legendaries. The legendaries, the real deal. Rulers of time, space, water, earth, sky, basically the most powerful beings to ever exist in the Pokemon world. Which is also why we catch... them. Yeah, Hyrei, Kyogre and Groudon are having a quarrel again. Could you please tell them to stop? Their antics are disturbing me at... work. Of course, I just have to beat this human called Youngster Joey and his stupid Rattata.
You see, they challenged us and called me, and the trainer who caught me, a weakling.
And now, obviously, we have to show them what real power looks like and...
Rattata, use agility!
Holy shit, would you stop spamming this? Hello, anyone there?
So yeah, let's just stick with Kyogre and Groudon, because their entries kinda imply just what a great power and scale their abilities have. Kyogre is named in the mythology as the Pokemon that expanded the sea by covering the land with torrential rains and towering tidal waves. It took to sleep after a cataclysmic battle with Groudon. Groudon has appeared in mythology as the creator of the land. It sleeps in magma, underground, and is said to make volcanoes erupt on awakening. This is their size compared to the player's character. That description led me to believe that they are at least 160 feet tall, which is still nothing compared to Kaijus or the king himself. I think I will end the video here. Yeah, given how many Pokemon there are, I could probably make a 30-minute video about this. But I think by now we all get the idea, and yeah, it gets kinda repetitive after a while. Oh, and a little fun fact, this video is actually a remake. I did it back then when I made my video still in German, but I don't know, I really liked the idea, the topic, the editing in the video, and said to myself, I should recreate this in English. And yeah, it's pretty similar, but also a nice comparison to look how my style and editing has changed and improved over time. So if you are interested, the link is in the description. Anyway, thank you so much for watching my video. Let me know what you thought, how big or small they would be, and... Oh, wait a second. Let me just save my file. Here we go. Power out.